ANN, artificial neural network. Basically, the topic is neural network. Neural network is basically linked with, you know, biological activity of a human being. When we are talking about the artificial neural network, it means it is a network which is just like a neural network of a human being, and but it is done artificially. So the term artificial neural network is derived from a biological. It is derived from the biological neural networks that develops the structure of a human brain. It is just like a in a human body, it all connected with the neurons. So neuron is just like this diagram. It has dendrite like this. These threads are what we call dendrites. There is a cell nucleus, and there is a arm which connect with this cell with the, that is what we call synapse, and this is axon. So similar to the human brain, that has the neuron interacted to one another. Artificial neural network also have the neurons that are interconnected to one another in various layers of the network. These neurons are known as nodes. So basically, we found in a human body, it is a cell, it is a kind of cell neuron which is connected throughout the body, and it connects the body with the brain and what we call our nervous system. There are two nervous system in our body, one is your backbone, spinal cord, and another is your brain. So whenever just for an example, let us suppose you have a cut on your hand. So you feel some pain, kind of pain, and why you feel pain there? Because your body is get connected with the brain through a chain of neuron. This is a one neuron I'll show you, but there are billion or millions of neurons in our body. So once there is a cut in at your hand, thus information is sent to your brain through this neuron, and then on the kind of information received by the brain, the brain will tell you what the necessary reaction you have to take. So basically, the information is passed through this synapse, and it is taken through dendrite. So this is a sort of a sensor in our body. So scientists saw this and they found this, and they tried to design this kind of neuron artificially. That is what we call ANN. So let's see, in a body, the typical artificial neural network looks something like this. It is an input set of nodes, then each node has certain weights, then neuron, and this neuron will then process it as to the brain, and then it is given as an output. So if you want to design this kind of neuron artificially, so you have to design it like this. You have to, here there is a comparison, means how dendrites is equivalent to the artificial neural network. In dendrites is equivalent to inputs, your inputs, and cell nucleus is nothing but the nodes. Synapse is the weights, and axon is the output. So let me describe it once again. This is the basic structure of the neuron. This is very important. And whenever we want to design an artificial neural network, we also designed it like this. Dendrites is just like an input. Similarly, a cell nucleus is just like a nodes. Similarly, and after that, axon is a neuron or the weights. And the synapse is, it's a kind of output. So one thing is particular here. See how our brain works. Whenever we take some input, how our brain recognizes it, that a round ball, let us suppose I'll show some round figure to the, to the machine. Then that round figure may be an apple, maybe a football, maybe anything. So how, since we have eyes, eyes as a sensor, which can also, you know, take the real photograph of that particular figure. So we can identify that yes, it is a ball, it is a apple, it is something else. But how this the same thing can happen in how the same thing can happen in the machine, how the machine can identify this. So for this, definitely it you know, take as an input a round figure. Then there are, you know, certain weights of identifying the things. Like once you have a round figure, you have, you know, certain weights of a color to the, you know, some sort of periphery and some sort of other features. So all other features have, you know, different weights. Like color has, definitely it has a more weight, because sometimes we can identify of any, you know, object by its color easily. So if it is a red in color, so probably the chances of being an apple is, you know, more. But also if the figure is round and it is red in color, maybe it is a ball. So you can't say only through this, you know, one input that it is a apple or a ball. Similarly, we have to check some other features, whether it is shiny or some other features which proves that it is a, you know, apple, or it's a orange, or it's a ball, or whatsoever. So basically these weights are, you know, are capable for design, for, you know, identifying the object. Let us suppose a face recognition. If we are talking about face recognition through ANN, so face, how the eyes are recognized. See, first the image is given to the as an input, then that image is, you know, discretely subdivided into different parts. So that different part, that depends upon how, you know, how long we take the inputs, how many features we will take. Sometimes we will take only two features, sometimes we will take, you know, more than two or three features. So, and, you know, once the face is detected on a face, you know, the periphery is one of the major factor, means it is a circular or a oval or something straight. So the weight is given to that according to the object. Similarly, eyes have a different weights, mouth has a different weight, teeth has a different weight. So we generate a expression here by multiplying x1 with w1, x2 with w2, plus 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 plus, means this multiply by this, plus this multiply by this, plus. Similarly, we have, you know, a sort of equation with us. So once we calculate that expression, we can, you know, we have a certain kind of number. We will have some number here. So, and we also apply the machine learning algorithm there. According to the machine learning algorithm, if we already set, you know, one critical limit, let us suppose 9.7. So once the value, this value, the altogether value comes through this is less than 9.7, we will say it is not a, you know, face. Or once its value is more than that particular value, that critical value that we set, for example 9.7, then we will say yes, this may be the face of a human being. I think you all understand. Basically, instead of you know, taking a object altogether, we take its discrete components with the discrete weights, and then we generate an expression by simply multiply this with this, add this with this, plus this into this. Then we have an expression, we calculated that expression, and we have a certain limit using machine learning. And if that particular limit, if the value falls within that particular limit, then we will say true or false depending upon the algorithm that we used there. And thus in this way this process is working. So I hope everybody understand. आपको करना क्या होता है, आपको यहाँ पे एक फेस या कोई भी जो भी चीज़ आपने दी है एज एन इनपुट, उस इनपुट के कुछ, जैसे कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट है, तो उस ऑब्जेक्ट के डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फीचर्स होते हैं, यहाँ पे डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फीचर्स होंगे और उन फीचर्स की अलग अलग इंपॉर्टेंस होगी. लेट अस सपोज मुझे एक फेस को पहचानना है, तो ऑब्वियसली अगर वो फेस एनिमल का है या मैन का है, कैसे पता लगेगा? तो भाई उसके अंदर हम उसकी आईज के भी पैरामीटर्स, आईज को भी देखेंगे, उसके नोज़ को भी देखेंगे और उसके लिप्स को भी देखेंगे. क्योंकि और उसकी और भी कई फीचर्स देखेंगे, उसकी आईज, लिप्स, आईब्रो, क्योंकि जनरली एनिमल्स की आईब्रो नहीं होती है, तो एनिमल की आईब्रो नहीं होती है, तो अगर आपको एनिमल और मैन को डिस्टिंग्विश करना है या लेडीज़ को जेंट्स से ज़्यादा डिस्टिंग्विश करना है, तो आपको कुछ ना कुछ ऐसे फीचर्स चेक करने पड़ेंगे जो एक्सक्लूसिवली मेल के अंदर होते हैं, फीमेल के अंदर नहीं होते हैं, या एनिमल के अंदर होते हैं, मेल के अंदर नहीं होते हैं। तो ये वेट जो है ये उसी के अकॉर्डिंगली सेट किया जाता है कि हम किस चीज़ को चेक कर रहे हैं। जैसे आप मैन और वुमेन को चेक कर रहे हो तो ऑब्वियसली हम बियर्ड चेक कर लेंगे कि दाढ़ी है, मूछें हैं, तो अगर है तो वो मैन हो जाएगा। तो इस तरीके से उस पर्टिकुलर कैटेगरी को हम वेट ज़्यादा दे देंगे, और बाकी सारे ये तो जूट चेक करेंगे पहले, सबसे पहले कि इंसान की फ़ोटो है भी कि नहीं है। तो इंसान की फ़ोटो है कि नहीं है तो उसके लिए हमें उसे पेरिफेरी चेक करनी पड़ेगी कि सर्कुलर है, और यू नो उसके दो ईयर ईयर की पोजीशन है कि नहीं है। तो कुछ कुछ फीचर्स हमें चेक करने पड़ेंगे, और उसके बाद हमें उसके मेन फीचर्स को चेक करने पड़ेंगे। इसलिए ये समटाइम्स व्हाट विल हैपन, द ऑल फीचर्स आर नॉट यू नो कैलकुलेटेड एट वन लेयर, देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लेयरिंग। तो हम क्या करते हैं, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट लेयर्स को बीच में बना देते हैं। दिस इज ऑल्सो वट वी कॉल डीप लर्निंग, इफ यू हर्ड अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म। उसके अंदर हम सिंगल न्यूरॉन ना लेकर के मल्टीपल लेयर्स ले लेते हैं। मल्टीपल लेयर्स में क्या होता है, फर्स्ट लेयर पे कुछ आइडेंटिफाई हो जाएगा कि येस ये मैन हो सकता है। सेकेंड लेयर में हम उसके और डीप जाते हैं, मतलब उसके और डीप स्टडी करते हैं, कुछ और डीप एनालिसिस फीचर्स को स्टडी करते हैं कि वेदर इट इज़ अ फेस ऑफ अ मैन और एन एनिमल। सो दिस हाउ यू नो इमेज क्लासिफिकेशन कैन बी डन। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड, दिस इज़ अ सिंगल लेयर स्ट्रक्चर। आई विल शो यू इन द लेटर सेक्शन, आई विल शो यू यू नो हाउ द मल्टीपल लेयर्स कैन बी यूज फॉर आइडेंटिफाइंग द फेस। सो लेट्स डू दिस। ये आपको समझ में आ गया होगा। ये मैंने बताया है कि आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क में और बायोलॉजिकल न्यूरल नेटवर्क में क्या रिलेशन है। बायोलॉजिकल न्यूरल नेटवर्क में देयर आर डेंड्राइट्स विच इज इक्विवेलेंट टू यू नो इनपुट्स इन द आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क। सिमिलरली देयर इज अ सेल न्यूक्लियस विच इज इक्विवेलेंट टू द नोड्स इन द आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क। साइनैप्स और देयर इज अ वेट, एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट यू नो साइनैप्स एंड वेट, क्योंकि वेट से ही आप चीज़ को कैटेगराइज करोगे कि ये चीज़ क्या है। एक्सॉन इज फॉर टेकिंग एन डिसीजन विच इज वॉट वी कॉल्ड आउटपुट। सो एंड आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क इज अ फील्ड ऑफ ए आई वेयर इट अटेम्प्ट टू मिमिक द नेटवर्क ऑफ न्यूरोन्स मेक अप अ ह्यूमन ब्रेन सो डैट कंप्यूटर्स विल हैव एन ओपिनियन ऑप्शन टू अंडरस्टैंड थिंग्स एंड मेक डिसीजन्स इन अ ह्यूमन लाइक मैनर। जैसे इंसान सोचता है, इंसान भी लेयर्स में सोचता है। यू नो आपने कभी कभार देखा होगा कि कुछ चीज़ें तो हमें बिल्कुल याद आ जाती हैं जो हमने बचपन में कभी स्कूल के टाइम पे कभी कुछ किया हो, और कभी कभार हमें यह भी याद नहीं रहता कि हमने रात को क्या खाना खाया। तो इट ऑल यू नो स्टोर्ड, ह्यूमन ब्रेन एक इनफाइनाइट यू नो मेमोरी है, ये इसकी कैपेसिटी कुछ नहीं है, इसकी कैपेसिटी इनफाइनाइट है। आपको याद आने को पिछले जन्म की चीज़ें भी याद आ जाएंगी, और ना याद आने को आपको ये भी नहीं याद रहेगा कि कल क्या किया था और आज क्या किया था। इट्स टोटली यू नो योर एबिलिटी टू यू नो रिट्रीव द इंफॉर्मेशन। तो आप कहोगे सर हम कैसे ब्रेन को तेज कर सकते हैं, सिमिलरली वही आपने तो सुना होगा, मेडिटेशन करो, आप एक्सरसाइज करो, आपके एक्टिव होने चाहिए पूरी बॉडी, तो आप इजीली यू नो अपने आप को जो रिकॉल कर सकते हो चीज़ों को। कई लोग होते हैं बिल्कुल डम से होते हैं, खाना खाया वहीं सो गए, मतलब फैटी होते हैं, और जो आप कह सकते हो कोई एक्टिविटीज़ कम करते हैं तो उनका ब्रेन भी सुस्त होता है, तो उसके अंदर भी वो इंफॉर्मेशन जो है इजिली रिट्रीव नहीं हो पाती है। सो बट दैट इज़ यू नो डिफरेंट थिंग विच इज़ नॉट, वी आर नॉट एबल टू यू नो पुट इट इन टू आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क। ANN आर्टिफिशियल के अंदर तो आपने जो चीज़ डाल दी है, तो इट इज़ सिंस इट इज़ अ मशीन, इट विल डेफिनेटली विल कम अप विद द रिजल्ट, वेदर इट इज़ स्टोर्ड यस्टरडे और यू नो स्टोर्ड बिलियंस ऑफ ईयर अगो, इट विल डेफिनेटली कम अप बिकॉज इट इज़ अ मैकेनिकल थिंग, और जो भी आपने इसके अंदर डाला होगा वही आएगा। इट विल नॉट यू नो गो बियॉन्ड द आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स और आपको कुछ नया रिजल्ट देगा, लेकिन हाँ डेफिनेटली व्हाट्स एवर द डाटा इज स्टोर्ड, मतलब स्टोर्ड दैट कैन बी यू नो रिट्रीव द रिजल्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट। सो आई होप एवरीबडी अंडरस्टैंड, द आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क इज डिजाइंड बाई प्रोग्रामिंग कंप्यूटर्स, यस कंप्यूटर से बनाया जाता है, टू बिहेव सिंपली लाइक अ इंटरकनेक्टेड ब्रेन सेल्स लाइक वट वी कॉल यू नो न्यूरॉन। सो देर आर अबाउट 1000 बिलियंस, मैंने बताया आपको 1000 बिलियन न्यूरॉन्स होते हैं ह्यूमन ब्रेन के अंदर। ईच न्यूरॉन इज एसोसिएटेड विद सम पॉइंट्स वेयर समवेयर इन द रेंज ऑफ 1000 एंड द मिलियन इन द ह्यूमन ब्रेन। Data is stored in a such a manner as are distributed, and we can extract more than one piece of this data when necessary from our memory parallelly, जो मैंने अभी आपको बताया. We can say that human brain is made up of incredibly amazing parallel processors. हमारे दिमाग के अंदर बहुत सारे प्रोसेसर थे, मतलब जो ये भगवान ने हमारा दिमाग बनाया, this is something amazing, you know, you can't produce artificially, but yes, we can made, you know, almost 1% or 2% of that by artificial intelligence. So we can understand the artificial neural example with an you can understand ANN with an example. Consider an example of digital logic circuit that takes an input and gives the output, like an OR gate, which takes two input. If one of the one or both of the inputs are on, then we get on in the output. Like a basically हमारी बॉडी के अंदर भी लॉजिक सर्किट्स की तरह इन्होंने बॉडी को कंस्ट्रक्ट किया, क्योंकि हमारी बॉडी में भी क्या होता है, जब कोई सेंसर से आपकी बॉडी कोई चीज़ रिसीव करती है, तो आप या तो एक्शन लोगे या नहीं लोगे, या वन होगा या ज़ीरो होगा. तो इट इज़ जस्ट लाइक अ यू नो डिजिटल एक्टिविटी. डेट इज़ वाई वी क्रिएटेड द होल बॉडी, यू नो, विद द हेल्प ऑफ द किड्स. आवर ब्रेन डज नॉट परफॉर्म द सेम टास्क. The output of the input relation keep changing because of the neurons in our body, which is what we call learning. हमारी body के अंदर जो होता है, human brain क्या करता है, आप जब भी कोई नया काम करते हो, तो according to the feedback means your experience, you stored it, you know, in somewhere in your mind. जैसे कि मैं आपको कहूँगा कि अगर एक मोमबत्ती के ऊपर आप अपना हाथ रखिए, जलती मोमबत्ती के ऊपर, आग के ऊपर हाथ रखिए, तो आप नहीं रखेंगे, just because आपने लर्न किया हुआ है कि आग के ऊपर हाथ रखेंगे तो आग आपकी उंगली को जला देगी या आपकी बॉडी जल जाएगी. ये आपने या तो एक्सपीरियंस किया होगा, या आपने बड़े बड़े को सीखा होगा, या कहीं ना कहीं से आपने ये एक्सपीरियंस किया है, या तो हीरियोस्टिक है, या आपने उसको करके देखा है कि भाई मैं अपनी उंगली रख के देखता हूँ ये जलती है कि नहीं जलती. जैसे ही आपने टच किया तो आग से आपकी उंगली जल गई, तो आपको समझ में आ गया कि यस, दिस इज़ डेंजरस, मैं अब इसको फ्यूचर में कभी नहीं करूँगा. And that is stored in your brain. In the same way, you know, we want the ANN, if we designed a machine, we want that, you know, the new experiences get stored inside the machine. And this is what we call machine learning, or in other words, what we call the deep learning, you know, use more than one network. So the architecture of the neural network, let's see. This is the architecture. I told you, you know, this is the first layer, and this is the output layer. This is the input layer. This is the output layer. See the color. The input layer is with the yellow color and the pink color of the output layer. And there are the number of, you know, hidden layers. And these hidden layers depend upon us. How much, you know, accurate we want to design our machine. Definitely, as the number of hidden layers increases, the number of, you know, the accuracy increases. But on the other hand, complexity and, you know, speed of the process is become high. Because agar aap jitni zyada hidden layers, ye hidden layers ko add karne ka matlab hai aap yahan pe neurons ko add kar rahe ho. To agar neurons ka ek network aap add kar rahe ho, to aap isko samjho ki jaise jaise aap neuron network ko add karoge, waise waise aapki cost badhegi system ki. So it is not, you know, very easy always to add a hidden layer. Although in the software you can do it, but practically agar aap kisi cheez ko kar rahe ho, to ek hidden layer ko ke upar kafi expense aata hai. So we are not, you know, always interested in putting these hidden layers, but yes, we are interested in, you know, to get a result accurate. So hum kya karte hain, is hidden layer ko ke andar number of nodes ko bada dete hain. Ye number of nodes jo hain, ye bhi hamare pe depend karti hain कि आपको नंबर ऑफ़ नोट्स कितनी लेनी है, आपने तीन लेनी है, चार लेनी है, कैसे लेनी है, ये आपके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है. तो आई होप एवरीबॉडी अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द लेयर एंड यू नो द नोट्स. दीज आर कॉल्ड नोट्स एंड दीज आर कॉल्ड लेयर्स. सो जनरली विद अ थंब रूल आई विल टेल यू कि हम ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा दो लेयर्स तक ही जाते हैं, बिकॉज कॉम्पिटिशन पावर भी ज़्यादा लगती है उसको कंप्यूट करने के लिए. आपको हाई एंड प्रोसेसर्स चाहिए होते हैं, तो जनरली हम दो लेयर्स तक ही जाते हैं, ज्यादा से ज्यादा तीन. बट हाँ, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द ऑपरेशन वी कैन, यू नो, मूव फॉर फोर और फाइव, यू नो, लेयर्स, बट नॉट मोर देन डैट. सो हमने एक प्रैक्टिकल में लैब में भी कुछ किया था, शायद ऐसा कुछ जहाँ तक मेरे ध्यान आ रहा है न्यूरल नेटवर्क पे. अदरवाइज वी विल डू वन, यू नो, प्रैक्टिकल ऑन न्यूरल नेटवर्क आल्सो. सो इनपुट लेयर क्या होती है? एज अ नेम सजेस्ट, इट एक्सेप्ट द इनपुट्स इन द सेवरल डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट्स. और देखो, इनपुट लेयर ने इनपुट लिया और उसने सेकेंड हिडन लेयर को ये दे दिया विद सर्टन वेट्स. द वेट्स आर देयर, डेफिनेटली देयर, बट इट इज़ नॉट शोन हेयर, बट देयर आर यू नो वेट्स. अब ये वाला फीचर जो है वो यहाँ पे भी यूज़ हो रहा है, यहाँ पे भी यूज़ हो रहा है, यहाँ पे भी यूज़ हो रहा है. समटाइम्स इट इज़ कनेक्टेड विद यू नो ऑल वन न्यूरॉन इज कनेक्टेड विद ऑल द न्यूरॉन्स. समटाइम्स इट इज़ कनेक्टेड विद यू नो सम स्पेसिफिक न्यूरॉन्स. सो इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द प्रॉब्लम. अगेन यू कैन कनेक्ट दिस नोड अनदर विद अनदर टू और अनदर थ्री और यू नो ऑल्टरनेटिव. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू बिकॉज आपको किस फीचर को ज़्यादा सेलेक्ट कर किस फीचर को ज़्यादा डेप्थ में ले जाना, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू. Sometimes we, you know, left one and we will take three forward. So this is also possible. So hidden layer, the hidden layer present in between input and the output layer, it performs all the calculation to find out the hidden features that I told you, no? Hidden layer क्या करती है और उसके जो features अपने front layer से cover नहीं करे, आप उसको और उसके depth में जा करके hidden layer से cover कर सकते हो. Output layer, output layer definitely it is used for you know the layer, the input goes through the series of transformation using the hidden layer which finally result in the output that is conveyed using this layer. This is what we call output layer. So I hope this is also you know easy, not too difficult, and this is very important. I told you this formula, the weight is multiplied with the you know inputs. See this, I told you here, this weight is multiplied with this, then add this, multiply with this, then add. This is just like a you know product and then addition, right? So this is the formula that is used for, and this is a B. What is B? Let's see. The artificial neural network takes input and computes a weight sum of the inputs, weighted sum. This is what we call weighted sum. This product is what we call weighted sum, and includes a bias. Bias is what? Bias is something you know which you add all together into all. Let us suppose you are identifying some object. Sorry. Let us suppose you are identifying some object, and that object has some you know feature which is already known. So we add that feature, that capability to all. This is something which is you know predetermined factor, that is what we call bias. So this bias is we added into this, and then we will check whether the altogether will check whether whether a particular value that we get from here is less than the critical limit or the more than the critical limit, and according to that we accepted it. So I will show you this in with some example. Now advantage of artificial neural network, this is very important, maybe you know asked to you in your exam. Number one is parallel processing capability. Now parallel processing capability is you know artificial neural network have a numerical value that can perform more than one task simultaneously. This is a you know advantage of ANN. Like you can perform many tasks simultaneously, and storing data on the entire network. This is again advantage of ANN. Data that is stored in traditional programming is stored as a whole network, not on a database. So this is again important. You know, storing of data is according to the node wise. Disappearance of a couple of pieces of the data in one place does not, you know, it does not affect the other because the data is stored at multiple places. So the storing data on an entire network, this is again an advantage of ANN. Capability to work with incomplete knowledge. Yes, because if you have certain, you know, certain sort of inadequate data, then also this will, you know, the ANN can use the training function and trained itself much better way and capable of you know giving you a most you know appropriate answer with less knowledge. So I hope you understand this, because sometimes you know ye kya karta hai, ye aapki jo bhi aapne isko knowledge diya ANN training se us knowledge ke jo bhi aapne knowledge usko incomplete diya ya thodi bahut bhi knowledge diya to wo with the stored libraries, you know, it can generate itself data, which can with the help of which it may produce an output even with the inadequate data. So this is again a feature of ANN. Until and unless we will do, you know, some practical on this ANN, we can't understand its functionality properly, but we will show you, you know, I will try to show you some experiment over there. So having a memory is to be able to adapt. It is important to determine the examples and to encourage the network according to the desired output by demonstrating these examples to the network. The succession of the network is directly proportional to the chosen instances. Yes, that I already told you. It depends upon, you know, number of layers and the number of nodes that you use in a particular network or a particular example. According to that, it will produce a result. So this is all just because of the memory distribution, because each layer is working, you know, independently. So I hope you understand. Having a fault tolerance. Extortion to one or more cell of ANN does not prohibit it generating output. Yes, this is again important, because since the working is, you know, working is happening in the different layers. If let us suppose one node is by chance it damaged or not working, then also, you know, the working is not stopped, because the working is capable, you know, it gets started through the another nodes. So this is another feature of ANN, like having fault tolerance, extortion of one or more cell. Agar ek se zyada cell kharab bhi ho jate hain, tab bhi aapko output mil jayega kuch na kuch, aur fault tolerance ki capabilities ke andar hoti hai. Now let us go for some disadvantage of ANN. This is again for very important for your exam. Disadvantage and advantage, maybe they will ask you what is advantages and disadvantages of ANN. So disadvantage is assurance of proper network structure. Yes, वही शो डैट, बट समटाइम क्या होता है कि कुछ लेयर्स के अंदर नोट्स ख़राब हो जाती हैं. सो देर इज़ नो पर्टिकुलर गाइडलाइन फॉर डिटरमाइनिंग द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ, और जहाँ पे कोई गाइडलाइन नहीं है कि आपको पहले में दो लेयर लिखनी है, दो नोट रखनी है, तीन रखनी है, कोई गाइडलाइन नहीं है. इट इज़ टोटली, यू नो, हिट एंड ट्रायल मैथड, एंड यू आर डूइंग इट अकॉर्डिंग टू योर एक्सपीरियंस, यू आर यूजिंग इट. सिमिलरली अनरिकॉग्नाइज बिहेवियर ऑफ अ नेटवर्क, इट इज़ अ मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट इशू ऑफ ANN. When ANN produces a testing solution, it does not provide insight concerning why and how. It decreases trust in the network. So recognized behavior of a network. It is a most significant issue of ANN. When ANN produces a testing solution, it does not provide insight concerning why and how. Means it will not tell you, you know, why and how that particular thing is taken. So that's why people lose trust in that network, because definitely it will produce the results, but how it is producing the result, that is not, you know, revealed. So that's why people sometimes have, you know, less trust on this network. If you have unstructured data or you have some, you know, ambiguous data with you. Hardware dependence, yes, this is another feature. Artificial neural network need processors, yes, and the power. So as you increase the layers, you know, that is why it is costly, you may say. So it is a hardware, totally hardware dependence. So difficulty of showing the issue to the network. ANN can work with numerical data. Problem must be converted into numerical values. Yes, because, you know, I told you the weights and the inputs that multiplied together and then sum. So it totally depend upon the, you know, numerical values of the values at the different instance, like input 1, input 2, input 3, it is also in the form of numerical values, and weights are also in the form of numerical values. So it is also, you know, sometimes it is difficult to showing the issue of the network, how, because the values are too discrete, we can't, you know, find out from where that particular glitch is coming. So this is the difficulty of showing the issue in the network, because sometimes if the results appears to be wrong, you can't, you know, identify from which node it comes, because it is too discrete to find out. The duration of network is unknown. The network is reduced to a specific value of an error, to the error, and this value does not give us optimum result. Sometimes what will happen, the network is reduced to a specific value of that I told you. that the value that you have at the end of the, you know, the neural network or the, at the output, this value does not gives us the optimum result. Sometimes it is not, you know, always optimum. So you have to, you know, increase the number of epoch. Epoch, I think you understand, epoch means, you know, it's in a recursion, the number of instances you are using is what we call epoches. So this is again a problem. Using an epoch means the duration of the network is unknown. Sometimes it will, you know, compute it within a time, within a speculated time, or sometime it will take, you know, more than specific times. So these are the certain limitations. So let me go back and tell you quickly advantages of ANN. That is, one is parallel processing, then storing data to the entire network, because data is, you know, uniformly distributed. So if somewhere some nodes are, you know, not working properly, then also it will not affect the whole network. Capability to work with the incomplete knowledge. Yes, this is an advantage. If we have, you know, certain some features are not there, so the ANN is self capable of generating the results, means generating the data. Capability to having a memory distribution, that's the same thing, storing data, and having fault tolerance. This is important. Fault tolerance means extraction of one or more of ANN does not prohibit it from generating output, and this features makes it the network, same thing, that if some nodes are not working, then also it will work. And disadvantage of ANN is assurance of proper network structure. We can't assure the network is properly, you know, structured. Unrecognized behavior of the network. Sometimes some nodes are, you know, we can't, you know, find out the through which node some ambiguity is coming. Hardware dependence, yes, hardware dependent. The whole process is depending upon the machine hardware. And if you need more layers, definitely you have to need more processing power, and the cost also. The difficulty of showing the issues to the network, yes, because all are numerical database, so it is very, you know, very difficult to find out the issues in the network. The duration of the network is unknown, because sometimes it will give you a result in a quick few seconds, and sometimes the neural network will, you know, compile its result within. It depends on the number of approaches also. If you use 1,000 approaches, sometimes it will give you a result depending on the data. It will give you the result within a seconds, or sometimes it will take, you know, a day or two. So that is why, you know, the people who are working in on ANN, they generally complained it that apna system unhone 2-3 din se chalaya hua hai, but still it is computing, it shows it is processing depending upon the GPU and CPU power available with you. So ये थोड़ी सी प्रॉब्लम है ANN के ऊपर, कि आपको एक हाई एंड प्रोसेसर चाहिए होता है जब भी आपको ANN जैसी टास्क के ऊपर काम करना है, क्योंकि एक इमेज को 1000 टाइम्स उसके फीचर को एक्सट्रैक्ट करना, मल्टीप्लाई करना, तो दिस विल नीड अ हाई एंड प्रोसेसर. सो हाउ डू आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क वर्क्स, दैट आई टोल्ड यू, यू नो, इट वर्क्स इन लाइक दिस. दीज आर द इनपुट्स, हिडन लेयर्स, दिस वी ऑलरेडी कवर्ड. या वन थिंग मोर, the error signal, see, input signal is computed by multiplying x with the weights, and also the error signal, you know, feed back to the network, so that next time that error signal will be also used to minimize the, you know, to increase the accuracy, you may say, or minimize the error in the whole circuit. So this is again an important point. Last and very very important two things we have to cover. One is binary. There is a two kinds of function is used. One is binary function, another is sigmoid function. Now, what is the difference between binary and sigmoid? Binary function is that will give result in the form of 0 or 1. Means, ya to wo cheez accept hogi us particular value se niche, ya reject hogi. So this is what we call binary. But sometimes it is not, you know, happened. Sometimes hume aisa bhi result chahiye hota hai ki jaise aap restaurant mein gaye khana khane, to aapse pucha khana acha hai ki ganda hai, to aap aise nahi bologe acha ganda, aap ye bhi bol sakte ho theek hai. So there is another, you know, marginal value is also there. कि ठीक है या बहुत अच्छा है या बहुत बुरा है या कम बुरा है या ज़्यादा बुरा है. So there are several others. That is why we use sigmoid hyperbolic function. So it is just like a S shape curve. If you heard about this, then it is okay. Otherwise, you have to learn this. In ANN, If you want a result either in the form of 0 and 1, then you have to use binary value, because I will show you one experiment in which, you know, there is a choice whether you want to choose a binary or you want to choose a sigmoid. So according to our problem, we will choose this function, because for setting up a ANN, you need a function also, and then that function is chosen by you. So we choose binary whenever we have to discretely, you know, classify into 0 and 1, and we use sigmoid function. Obviously, the sigmoid is, you know, much better than the binary, but this will compute more power. So this is again a very important, okay, we use two kinds of activation function. And one last thing, types of ANN. There are two kinds of ANN, feedback ANN and feed forward. Feed forward and feedback means simple. If the data is moving only, you know, in the this direction, this is what we call feed forward. And if the some, you know, sort of feedback or some error signal is feedback into this, so this is what we call feedback ANN. Obviously, the feedback ANN is capable of having more accuracy than feed forward. So feed forward means you have to put the inputs through the layer, through the input layer, and forward it to the hidden, then to the output. And feedback means the output signal, the output thus generated, if they have some error signal, it is feedback to the input layer, and according to which the next, you know, decision can be taken. So I hope you understand this feedback ANN. Feedback ANN, in this type of ANN, the output returns into the network and accomplish the best evolved result internally. आप कुछ output का कुछ part जो है वापस input में send कर देते हो, जिसकी वजह से वो अपने accuracy को बढ़ा सकता है. So this is what we call feedback ANN. And another type is feed forward ANN. A feed forward ANN is a basic neural network comprising of the input layer, same जो simple जो ANN होता है उसको हम feed forward ANN कहते हैं. So I hope this is enough for today's class, and you understand what is ANN.